we're going to New Jersey for work. It's going to be all work. And I think you see what's happened. The economy is maybe better than it's ever been. The numbers are coming out the best they've ever had. We just came out with youth numbers. They've been just fantastic, off the charts. So we're very happy about that. And I think for that reason, I think in November we're going to do extremely well, extremely well. I'd like to see twice, but we're going to see. This took place when I had, as you know, the world's top executives, among the world's top executives, and the head of Pepsi-Cola, a great woman who is now retiring. She said, because I asked, what could we do to make it even better? And she said, two time a year reporting, not quarterly. And I thought of it, and it made sense to me, because, you know, we are not thinking far enough out. We've been accused of that for a long time, this country. So we're looking at that very, very seriously. We're looking at twice a year instead of four times a year. I don't know, McRaven. I know that I've gotten tremendous response from having done that, because security clearances are very important to me, very, very important. And I've had a tremendous response for having done that. There's no silence. If anything, I'm giving him a bigger voice. Many people don't even know who he is, and now he has a bigger voice, and that's okay with me because I like taking on voices like that. I've never respected him. I've never had a lot of respect. And Senator Burr said it best, if you knew anything, why didn't you report it when you were before all of these committees, including their committee? So he had a chance to report, he never did. This was just came up lately, and it's a disgusting thing, frankly. Look, I say it again, that whole situation is a rigged witch hunt. It's a totally rigged deal. They should be looking at the other side. They should be looking at all the people that got fired by them. All of the people that got fired, they should be looking at Bruce Orr and his wife, Nellie, for dealing with, by the way, indirectly, Russians. They should be looking at Steele. They should be looking at all these FBI guys who got fired and demoted. It's a really weird, it's not us. It is a rigged witch hunt. I've said it for a long time. Say it. I think Bruce Orr is a disgrace. I suspect I'll be taking it away very quickly. I think that Bruce Orr is a disgrace with his wife, Nellie. For him to be in the Justice Department and to be doing what he did, that is a disgrace. That is disqualifying for Mueller. And Mr. Mueller has a lot of conflicts also, directly yourself, so you know that. Mr. Mueller is highly conflicted. In fact, Comey is like his best friend. I could go into conflict after conflict. But sadly, Mr. Mueller is conflicted. But let him write his report. We did nothing. There's no collusion. But if he was doing an honest report, he'd write it on the other side. Because when you look at criminality and you look at problems, take a look at what they did, including colluding with the Russians, the other side. I can't hear you too well. You have a helicopter. Well, Turkey's been a problem for a long time. They have not acted as a friend. We'll see what happens. They have a wonderful Christian pastor. He's a wonderful man, Pastor Brunson. They made up this phony charge that he's a spy, and he's not a spy. He's going through a trial right now, if you call it a trial. They should have given him back a long time ago. And Turkey has, in my opinion, acted very, very badly. So we haven't seen the last of that. We are not going to take it sitting down. They can't take our people. So you will see what happens. I don't talk about that now. I don't talk about that. I think the whole Manafort trial is very sad. When you look at what's going on there, I think it's a very sad day for our country. He worked for me for a very short period of time, but you know what? He happens to be a very good person. And I think it's very sad what they've done to Paul Manafort. Thank you very much.
Right there, very end, President Trump talking about Paul Manafort, saying he happens to be a very good person. Sad day. President had a lot on his mind as he's heading to Marine One to head out to the Hamptons right now. Let's talk about it. Joining me, Chris Eliza is here, CNN Politics reporter and editor-at-large. Caitlin Huey Burns is national political reporter for Real Clear Politics. And retired Rear Admiral John Kirby is here. He's a CNN military and diplomatic analyst, former spokesman for the Defense and State Departments under President Obama. Thank you all so much for being here. Chris, President Trump had a lot to say this morning. Mm-hmm. Specifically, let's start with the very big issue with real-life consequences, talking about revoking, stripping John Brennan of his security clearance, talking yep. about doing it to other people. And the president's response to questions about it today was, if anything, I'm giving him a bigger voice when it comes to Brennan, which I found fascinating, and also says return on his own to the whole thing is a witch hunt, the whole thing is a rigged deal.
Yeah, remember, but okay, a couple things. He's not wrong that John Brennan's getting a big megaphone from all this. That's point one. Point two, remember that the White House's official line via Sarah Sanders is that John Brennan's security clearance was taken away because he was sort of endangering the national security, broadly speaking. But Donald Trump, in a Wall Street Journal interview and then just then, seems to suggest that it's more about the negative things that John Brennan has said about the Russia investigation vis-a-vis Donald Trump than it is about any sort of broader national security concern. Remember, Kate, this is like pardons in a way. Things that Donald Trump can do unilaterally, that he likes doing because he can do them unilaterally. And I think that we will see more of, not less of. The thing that is remarkable in the way that Donald Trump phrased his response to the question about John Brennan, he said, it's getting a tremendous response. Now, he's right about that. He's right, it's getting a tremendous response. I don't know that he meant it in the way that it accurately reads, but such is life.
Just to offer some more context, I want to bring you in, John, on this. To offer some more context, this is what President Trump had told the Wall Street Journal after stripping Brennan of his security clearance. He had said to the Wall Street Journal, I call it a rigged witch hunt. It is a sham, and these people led it. So I think it's something that had to be done. But the White House has maintained, John, that it has to do with national security reasons, offering no proof about it. The pushback now from many heavyweights in the intelligence community, from McRaven to Michael Hayden to David Petraeus to Michael Morell to Robert Gates now joining on in this letter, can you offer some perspective of what this pushback kind of perspective on the pushback that the president is getting to this, even though he calls the response tremendous?
Well, I agree with Chris. It's tremendous, but probably not in the way that the president wants it to come across as. I mean, these are significant individuals, nonpartisan primarily, individuals in national security leadership positions or former, who have clearly identified what's really going on here. And they do believe it is an attempt to stifle criticism, but also it'll have a trickle-down effect, and they've noted it'll have a trickle-down effect on both current and former officials at much lower levels who will be more greatly affected by the chilling effect that this decision and these future decisions on security clearances will have. Number two, they have rightly noted that it will have, potentially could have, a negative impact on this administration and maybe even administrations going forward on their ability to reach out to these former officials and glean their wisdom and their experience about issues that they're dealing, that the current administration is dealing with. Now, look, it's not likely that Trump was going to reach out to Brennan or Hayden or Clapper anytime soon, but he is actually cutting his own nose off to spite his face when he sort of, you know, gives these guys the Heisman and cuts them off from the potential access to classified information. The last thing I'll say, Kate, is this was a classic, you know, White House message mismatch, say-do gap, right? I mean, Sarah Sanders went out and said that this was about Brennan's frenzied commentary and his erratic behavior, but the president just today and in that Wall Street Journal interview made it very clear that this was about retaliation for the Russia investigation and for Brennan's role in it.
I mean, if there's any question, I think he kind of puts it to rest with what he said just now. I mean, asked about, is he trying to silence critics? He goes to the taglines that he goes to all the time when it comes to the Russia investigation.
That is
it's
exactly
a rigged
right.
witch hunt. I've said it for a long time. I mean, there was nothing about national security concerns in his reasoning
today.
What
we know is that in his mind, it's linked. Right, because that's what he goes to, whether it's linked or not. But in his mind,
isn't that the only thing that matters? He's the only one with the power to strip the security.
Absolutely,
player.
And that's why I always listen to his tweets and listen to what he says, as opposed to listen to what the official White House response is.
Caitlin, let me bring you in. One person who's not a former, who's a current, mm-hmm. who President Trump brought up. Was asked about and also brought up is Bruce Orr, who mm-hmm. works at the Justice Department. And he said, right. and one of the, now my multiple pages of notes are off, but he said that I suspect I'll be taking it away very shortly. I mean, that was pretty declarative that Bruce Orr's security clearance is
right.
on the
outs. And Bruce Orr, of course, his wife, who Trump was referring to, worked for Fusion GPS, which of course is linked to that Steele dossier, that infamous dossier that is part of why Trump is, you know, feeds into what we were just talking
He's very
about.
Recently become a real foe for the president. Right.
And so certainly this is not just about John Brennan then, right? Because he has this list of other targets that seems to be kind of growing by the day. And what's really interesting to consider here is the way in which, first of all, Trump likes to have these foils, right? So he, in one way, he does not mind at all that Brennan is coming up because uh-huh. he can kind of use him as a punching bag continuously. But also what's really important to consider here is the reaction that we've seen on Capitol Hill, and the fact is that the president has not really suffered substantive political consequences for these actions. You're hearing from people like Lindsey Graham and other senators who don't think that Brennan is a sympathetic figure at all coming to the president's side. So the president feels like he has support there. And also, just in 2016, when you had those 50 Republican national security and intelligence officials coming out against the president, only to see the president reelected. So this kind of thing, I think, fuels him more than it stops him. So I'm waiting to see kind of what else this prompts him to do.
I do, exactly to Caitlin's point, Chris, I have found it fascinating in the response on Capitol Hill amongst Republicans. Some of the most, you know, pro-military, pro-intelligence, mm-hmm. hawkish Republicans, they are backing, many of them backing the president, especially when it comes to John Brennan.
Yeah, the one that stood out to me, first of all, I'm surprised too, Kate. The one that stood out to me was Orrin Hatch, who's retiring from the Senate in Utah, been in the Senate a very long time, said essentially, I'm surprised that the president didn't revoke Brennan's clearance sooner. He hasn't been a friend to this administration. That's not any reason why you revoke a security clearance. It's not about being friends or saying nice things. Kellyanne Conway said something similar this morning that, Brennan hasn't been a friend to us. That's not it, right? That's not, as Admiral Kirby mm-hmm. can speak to, that's not why security clearances get revoked. It is he Clapper speaking from classified information to criticize the president? There's no evidence that that's the case. So I think that's a very dangerous line, that dissent is enough to be something that you would revoke security clearance, which, as John makes a point, it doesn't really hurt Brennan. It hurts the sort of collected institutional wisdom sharing within the intelligence community.
Yeah, Michael Morell said this morning, and it's exactly kind of what you're saying, John, but Michael Morell said this morning, this doesn't hurt the individual. This hurts the government with this decision. But I think it's important to not get lost in this because it is so... We cover the president because he is speaking because he is the president of the United States as he is walking out of the White House and heading to Marine One and off to Air Force One. But not to get lost in this, John, is the perspective we're in this kind of odd, strange place where when it comes to this moment, it's the main story, the central story might actually be Omarosa and her book and tapes. And the distraction from the main story is this stripping of security clearances with real life kind of consequences that we're looking at, because the timing here has been, I just really want to make sure that it's not lost. The original statement, John, was, and you can speak to this as you've put out many statements as a spokesman for the Defense and State Departments, the original statement that went out stripping Brennan of his clearance was weeks ago, days after the president said he was reviewing it, but not released and but not announced until now. And of course, the Washington Post is reporting that it has a lot to do with the Omarosa situation, if you will.
Yeah, according to Post reporting, it was Sarah Sanders who wanted to keep that statement in the back pocket, as it were, and pull it out when they needed it. And they decided that now this week, with Omarosa's book out there, this was the time to do it. And look, it's despicable as a strategy and a tactic, but it kind of worked for them because this has overtaken
in many
ways.
And not to be Pollyanna, a lot administrations do this. White Houses do this. You release information for maximum impact. You know.
Hey, I cannot confirm or deny that I ever held on to a statement for a particular. Look, of course, when you're a government PR guy, you know, you think about the timing. Absolutely. But in this case, they would tell you it not only worked, but it worked to a fare thee well, because this is a big story. It's not just a small distraction, and we should be covering this. We should be debating the reasons behind it. It's a major, much more of a national security story than anything Omarosa's book has to say about Trump and his leadership style. So, I mean, it did work for them to a fairly well, but I don't think in the long run, even though Trump thinks he makes him look strong and this is getting him the tremendous response that he seems to be getting, I don't think in the long run that what they've done, what the president's considering doing with future clearances is good for this country, good for our national security, and quite frankly, I don't believe it's good for him and his administration.
No, but we do find ourselves, the president does find himself in, I don't know if we can just say, on familiar ground, going head-to-head with the intelligence community in the most public way possible now. Chris, great to see you. John, great to see you. Caitlin, thanks for coming in. Great to see you as well. I appreciate it.